What's up, y'all? Welcome to another edition of that Friday Show, boy. If it's your first time sliding through, you already know what to do. Hit that like, that sub, and please turn notification, y'all, because... Oh, I got y'all. Don't worry, I got y'all.
It's lit.
I've been seeing this guy all over Instagram, all over YouTube, okay? I guess he just got, arrested. We're about to find out what's going on with this guy, okay? It says here, the fake Nigerian billionaire. He's fake. He's been lying? You might check it out. So any further ado, let's go with Gee. Let's go, let's Gee.
Nigerian billionaire. Scrolling through the gram, as the kids call it, it can be easy to feel a bit less than. There are endless photos of millionaires and billionaires boarding their private jets. Photos of your friends in lavish locations and individuals traveling around the world doing things you could only dream of. A lot of people said...
Bruh. I dream of going to like an exotic place and like swimming booty naked, bruh, on an endless pool. You know those endless pools that look like they just keep going? I just want to do that butt naked. Judge me. I don't care.
Fake it on Instagram. After all, we all want to appear exciting, fabulous, and wealthy. But there are some take it a bit too far.
Sheesh.
And I'm not talking about any bad photoshops. I'm talking about using Instagram to help commit a cyber scam worth $430 million. Today, with...
$430 million scam?
We're going to talk about Raymond Arbus, or Hushpuppi, and the insane way he lied to the world and landed himself in prison. This is Raymond Arbus, and this is one of Raymond Arbus's mini cars. This Rolls-Royce Cullinan sells for a minimum of $340,000, and Raymond isn't shy about flaunting it. In fact, he's not very shy about flaunting anything. Private jet flights with Gucci and Louis Vuitton luggage.
Dang, bruh.
Expensive watches clasped around his wrist.
That's a Bugatti. That's a Bugatti right there.
Inside a Bugatti, he posted photos of him trotting around the globe. From sitting on a car worth hundreds of thousands of dollars under the Eiffel Tower to stepping out of his Rolls Royce in Dubai, one of the most luxurious cities on earth.
I need to follow this guy, period, bro.
That's not to mention the clothes he wore in all these locations. There's this picture he posted of just a fraction of his shoes. This custom Versace robe that he sported in front of two of his Rolls Royce cars. And of course, there are these watches, including this one, and of course this one. Oh, and this Richard Mille watch worth $150,000.
Bro, it's a special order for Ray Hush. What? How you get all this in the first place?
It's hard to imagine anyone having this kind of wealth. It's even harder to imagine this wealth disappearing in the blink of an eye in a single arrest. Because, after all, Raymond wasn't really a billionaire. Born in Nigeria, Raymond worked reselling secondhand clothing in the city of Lagos. During this time, he began to cultivate an Instagram following by posting a luxurious lifestyle. A lifestyle that wasn't actually his. And truly, that's a lot easier to do.
Bro, he went the salt pepper... Hang on, let me fix this. Bro, he out there with the salt guy?
Than many people realize. In Russia, there's a company that offers two-hour photography sessions on a grounded private jet for $224 a pop. A short private jet flight will normally run you $5,000 or so. So, if you want to look rich without really being rich, 2 hours on a grounded flight might seem like the more obvious way to go.
What the heck?
Raymond gained a lot of followers by presenting a lavish lifestyle. As his social media account began to grow, so did his plan. He marketed himself as a real estate investor and posted inspirational quotes about staying hungry and working hard to achieve success. People were drawn to him, and that created a huge following of victims that Raymond could prey on. At his peak, his account had 2.4 million Instagram followers, and a ton of them would be sending him money. money, he and a group of 11 others created fake websites for well-known companies and banks to steal credit card information.
Wow. No, this guy didn't. Wow.
After people fell for the scam, they would launder the stolen money and be on their happy way. Well, that was until they got caught, that is. In early 2020, the police in Dubai burst into Raymond's apartment in the early morning. They arrested him, as well as his 11 co-conspirators, for money laundering, hacking, scamming, and cyber fraud.
Oh, he crying, bruh. You can tell he crying. That's what you get for freaking, robbing people, bruh. Or scamming people. Raid,
the police found an impressive stash. They discovered $37 million in cash in the home, most of which... was stuffed into suitcases. Upon further investigation, it was discovered that there were over 2 million scam victims. Most of the victims are from the United States, but dozens are from Nigeria and Europe.
No.
And cash and victims aren't the only thing they found. In the raid, 21 laptops, 47 smartphones, 15 memory sticks, 5 hard drives, and 13 luxury cars were seized. And those 13 cars alone were worth $6.28 million.
Wow, what is this guy?
Since his arrest, Raymond has been extradited to the United States. He's currently in jail in Chicago, but is expected to be moved to Los Angeles within the next few months.
Oh, he's down the street from me.
It's hard to imagine that someone who was posting this just a short bit ago is now sitting in a cell in an orange jumper. He was just living in the Palazzo Versace in Dubai, a 5-star hotel with luxury apartments. His home there had Versace art on the wall.
Dude, bro, look at this guy, yo. Flexing.
Parquet flooring and full service. I have a feeling he'll never be experiencing that again. Especially with how long he'll be put away for. That just goes to show you, friends. Cheaters never win. If you want success, do it the old-fashioned way.
You gotta work your tail off.
There you have it. The fortune of the fake Nigerian billionaire.
Wow.
It just serves as a reminder to not believe everything you see on social media.
Wow.
Thanks for watching. As always, I'm Mr. Luxury. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to leave
I like your video, Mr. Luxury.
Notifications. I'll catch you next time.
I like your video, Mr. Luxury. Wow. Yo, first off, y'all, comment below, man. I've been seeing this guy over. I was like, who is this guy, man? He was faking it till he got caught, bro. You usually fake it till you make it. He faked it till he got caught, bro. That's what happened to him, bro. That's crazy, man. Request more stuff to get through in the comment section below. And until next time, I'll let you lay out. I'm out on 3123. Huh? Deuce.